Have you heard about Butterbell? What is the perfect way to sterilize the kitchen sponges? What should be the right wattage for a mixer grinder? Let's find all the answers here in this video. Namaste, welcome to Home Hashtag Life. These are everyday small tips and hacks that I have learned from various people over the time. From family, from friends, from experience, from research, from you guys. I hope you will find them useful as well. So let's get started. How many times dal has spilled from the pressure cooker? If you are wondering, then hear me out. During the research, I get to know that lentils and legumes contain saponins. When water entered the seeds during boiling, the saponin gets dissolved and lathers up in water just like soap. Isn't it an interesting fact to know? So when we overwater, it creates more foam which causes the spill. Now to avoid the spillage, I follow these simple steps. Wash and soak the dal for 1 hour. If you want to know why, then you can check this video. Then in a pressure cooker, add the dal and water. Now here we have to be careful. Add water only till the dal gets soaked. Not more, otherwise it will cause foaming and spilling. Then add a little oil or ghee, which means any kind of a fat, along with salt and turmeric. There will be less chances to spill and mess. Try it and let me know if this works for you. Many times we find peeling boiled eggs is difficult. Very often we end up messing up the whole peeling and end up with random looking eggs. To avoid this, the key here is to follow a simple step. Boil the water, put the eggs inside the boiling water, boil them for 10 to 12 minutes, empty the hot water and fill it with cold water. Let it sit for 5 to 10 minutes. Though ice works best, cold water does the job well too. Crack the fat portion first as it has an air pocket. I have learned this fact on usrepresented.com, so it will be easier to separate the inner and outer membrane. Interesting, no? Ta-da! See, it's all about science. Mostly we have tea, whether it's a masala chai or adrak wali chai. But when tea leaves get finished, the leaf dust at the bottom makes the tea very difficult to have, especially the last couple of sips. I have found a solution. Let me know if it is working for you as well. Take a sieve and dust the tea well. This way all the loose fine dust will fall off easily through the sieve. Then store it back. This way, the tea dust won't get into your mouth and ruin our mood of sipping garma garam adrak wali chai. I have a dishwasher and that easily helps me maintain the glass oil jars. But earlier, I used this trick. Simply put some rice grains inside the jar, add water with a spot of dish soap, nicely swirl and shake. Through this abrasion process, rice grains will help remove all grease. Now pour some hot water and rinse it thoroughly. If you need to remove strong masala smells from the bottles to repurpose them, all you need to do is pour vinegar inside the container. Lock it nicely, leave it overnight, and then the next day wash the bottle with soap. Let it dry under the sun if possible. It will take out the vinegar smell as well. Repeat the process if needed. It took me 2 days to take out the garlic smell from this glass container. Yes, glass containers do absorb smell, but I have found vinegar does the job well because it has an astringent property. Voila, no smell. Just give a good wash and you are good to go. There are two types of hing available in the market. One is powdered hing, which we normally use, and another one is compound hing. The powdered hing is good, but compound hing or block one is even better. So next time when you are out of hing powder, try this compound one. Take a small piece, grind it in a mortar pestle, and then add it in tadka. Little closer to the purest form and the aroma will be fantastic. Use very little because otherwise it leaves a bitter taste along with the other health problem. This tip includes an important info on sponges or scrubber. So listen carefully. We all use this type of sponge scrubber daily in our kitchen to scrub our dishes. As we all know that kitchen sponges are the hub of bacteria. Me as a finicky cleaner started doing little research about the right process of cleaning these kitchen sponges. And for the very first time while researching, I heard a term CFU formula, colony forming unit. I'm not going into details about the bacteria counts and all because that's rather scary than interesting, but you make sure after scrubbing the dishes, clean it thoroughly and squeeze it nicely before storing back.
A dirty and wet sponge holds more bacteria than a thoroughly rinsed and squeezed one. And what's the best way to sterilize it? Microwave it. Put it in a dishwasher. The best way is to boil the sponge for 5 minutes once in every few days, help to sterilize it to some extent.
These sponges are really high quality. Do not throw them unnecessarily. Boil it, sterilize it, and keep using them.
When next time you buy a mixer grinder, pay attention to the wattage before buying. What is the unit of power? For normal to medium usage, 500 watt is fine. But higher wattage is useful to grind tougher ingredients at a faster speed. If you are dry grinding masalas every week or using the mixer to make nut butters, grinding idli dosa batter or chutney every week, then go for higher watt like 750 watt or even 1000 watt according to your home usage. This one is 750 watt and I found it quite helpful and useful. From my 10 years of homemaking experience, I can assure you that higher watt power will help you handle heavy duty grinding, the butter will not heat easily and it will last long. This would be an interesting product for your small kitchen where every square inch is a treasure for us. If you don't have any place to dry your kitchen rags or vegetable bags, then use this clip hanger. It has 10 clip pegs and we can hang grocery bags or kitchen cloths, mats and whatnot to dry. Though it's meant for baby clothes or socks, but I found it useful for kitchen necessities. A butter bell or a butter crock is a beautiful piece of crockery that originated from Europe, especially France. When we want to use the refrigerated butter immediately, we never get the pleasure of spreading it smooth onto anything because it's hard. So here is a butter keeper that you can place on the countertop or on the dining table, which is very convenient to use. Pour some water in this container, it's called crock. Now fill up the cup with the butter and then place the lid onto the crock. The water creates an airtight seal by keeping the butter covered, hence preventing any bacterial or mold formation. Butter is always soft and creamy and easy to spread and doesn't spoil even when left outside. Make sure to keep only the amount which you will be consuming within 2 weeks and change the water in every 2 to 3 days. This is so interesting and so classy. I simply fell in love with this butter keeper.
Be sure to give this video a big thumbs up if you found these tips interesting and useful. Do try them out and don't forget to comment which one really helped you. Thank you so much for watching. Subscribe to Home Hashtag Life and you can always find us here for more videos, pictures and life updates. I will see you in the next one. Till then, take care. Bye-bye.